Are you here to take me?
No, Howard. I'm here to ride the F train with you.
Oh, okay.
So, there are these two twins in a womb, a boy and a girl.
You're telling a joke?
No, no, it's a story. So these twins are happy. You know, they're fed, they're warm, they feel safe, but they're outgrowing their space. And they realize this can't go on forever. So they start thinking, what comes next? What if it's cold or lonely? What if we're not together? What if there's nothing at all? So then the girl looks at the cord. You know, this cord that has fed them, has nourished them. This cord that they can't possibly conceive could be attached to anything else. And she says, well, we have no proof. All we have is this.
Oh. Wow, that's deep. So it's like life after birth. Hopeful. All right, what do you want? Why are you here? I've heard all of your platitudes. I got them, I know. She's in a better place. And this is all a part of a master plan. Heard that one too. Here's my favorite. God looked down and saw the most beautiful rose, so beautiful that he picked it to have it in heaven all for himself. Then there's the science, biocentrism, and we're all living and dying in infinite universes all at the same time. And then the religion, the Christians and their salvation, and the Buddhists and their samsara, and the Hindus and their 41st sacrament. And can't forget the poetry. Oh, the poetry. To die is different from what anyone supposed. And luckier, Whitman. And rage! Rage against the dying of the light. The wise men at their end know dark is right. Thomas. And then row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. I got it. I got it. It all basically says that you're a natural part of life. We shouldn't hate you. We shouldn't fear you. I guess we should just accept you, right? That's it. I get it. Here's the thing. It's all a bunch of intellectual bullshit. She's not here holding my fucking hand.